You can't solve current problems with the same level of thinking that created the problem in the first place. Should I have a business coach? I believe, simply stating, that every business owner, regardless of your business, regardless of the industry of your business, should have someone that has an outside perspective of your business, but understands and has obviously credibility within business, within the understanding of the different aspects of business. Business is complicated. You know, I try to simplify it the way I talk about it and the way I understand it. I simplify it to like four M's: mindset, marketing, management, and money. It's just a way to compartmentalize those four M's. Mindset is really about leadership, how you think, how you act as the leader of your business. Marketing obviously is generating referrals to your business, and you can include sales on that and converting your referrals into new patients and converting your new patients into a plan of care so they come in for their visits. And of course, management is organization of your business and the hiring of people, the systems that are put in into your business. And then the other M is money. Money is the financials of your business, the metrics of your business. So these are the four M's of business. And not having someone else to become accountable to, not having someone else to think through the problems and the challenges that happen day in and day out in these four areas of your business puts you at a disadvantage. I think it was Albert Einstein who said this. I'm not positive, but he said, you can't solve current problems with the same level of thinking that created the problem in the first place. What does that mean? If there's an issue going on in your business and you're the owner, so the decisions you made created this problem, then if you don't change how you think, then you are never going to change the problem because you're the one that's creating it. So how you think created the problem. So we need to think differently about our business. Well, reading books is good, taking programs, watching videos, all of that is good, but having someone to bounce ideas off of, to be accountable to make sure that the way I look at coaching, and I've had a coach almost my whole business life, having a coach keeps you within the guardrails on the road, but doesn't let you go over the ledge. Having a coach doesn't mean not having problems. Having a coach is not solving everything for you. That is not what a high-level coach is. Having a coach is a guide. A coach is a guide. I love the Rocky movies. Big Rocky fan. Rocky's the hero. Mickey, the trainer, was the guide. Mickey helped guide Rocky. Mickey could not train Rocky to do it. He didn't do the work for Rocky. He couldn't get Rocky to get up and Rocky too to get up and finally win the belt. He couldn't do those things for Rocky. But you know what he could do? He can instill confidence in Rocky when Rocky was down. He can give Rocky hope. He can give Rocky a path and a plan to help him achieve his goals. He can inspire him when he needs it. He can prevent Rocky from going down a bad path and hanging with the bad people and making the bad decisions. Now, Rocky still could make those bad decisions. You can't force someone to do it. But I think a lot of times with coaching, business coaching, first of all, business coach should have intimate knowledge about business and about the experiences that you're going through. There should be a path. There should be a plan, like a step-by-step plan. It shouldn't just be whatever. There needs to be a plan. There needs to be a clear direction in business. Obviously, the credibility and the authority, and it's someone that should jive with you, connect with you, understand you. Those are just some traits that I use to hire a coach. But by no means is the coach going to do it for you. And what I've heard, and the reason I haven't had a coach my whole business life, because for the first 4 or 5 years in business, I had a big ego. And my ego was, I don't need someone to help me. I can figure it out myself. Because I went through school figuring out things basically myself. And I took that attitude of being this rugged individualist and did it myself. Well, I heard a quote that says, if you want to go fast, do it yourself. But if you want to go far, get the help of others. And once I realized I wanted to go far, I had a vision of where I wanted my business to be. I wanted this idea of practice freedom to be able to work when I want, make the money I want, and have a team in place to do it and have a business that runs like clockwork. I knew I needed guidance on that. That's my perspective on whether you need a coach or not. If you're not coachable, don't waste your money on a coach. If you're not open to new ideas, don't waste your money on a coach. But if you are, then it should be the best investment you ever do. And if it's not an investment, if you don't look at it as an investment should get the things you want back. One of them is specifically, it should be getting money back that you're investing. If you're not looking at it like that, don't hire a coach if you're seeing it as a cost.